All right, there's that latest forecast cone from the National Hurricane Center, the brand new advisory holding winds at 105 miles per hour. So we haven't seen a whole lot of change here with the current status of the storm, and really very little change. If you look here on first glance and the forecast cone, the Hurricane Center may be slowing down the motion of the storm a little bit. And also another change here is that we've seen just a slight adjustment a little bit farther south. And that's because we've seen some trends overnight with some of the hurricane models that want to bring the storm in again. We're starting to see more agreement closer to south and central Florida. And there's still a wide margin of error here once you get closer to day four and day five. So the expectation is now that we're going to see a major hurricane, likely a category four storm, make landfall over the Florida East Coast, the southern part of Florida, and then it's going to take a turn. And is it going to take the turn a little bit earlier before the coast? You can see that's also a possibility, probably a less likely possibility at this point. Most of our computer guidance brings us in with a landfall over South Florida and then gradually makes that turn. We would be on the western side the way things are looking right now, which means we'll likely see some fringe effects Monday into Tuesday. It's too early here. We're talking about 4 or 5 days out. Just too early to get down into specifics for your communities, whether if you're thinking what we're going to see here in Lehigh Acres, what we're going to see in Clewiston, Cape Coral. Now, I can tell you, if you live farther inland, closer to Lake Okeechobee, that's likely where we're going to see the worst conditions because you are going to be closer to the core of the storm. Here's what Dorian looks like on satellite imagery this morning. It looks like we've got a little bit of shear, just looking from the satellite imagery, beginning to get to the southwestern side of the storm. So the winds are coming in aloft and maybe making it look a little less formidable on the satellite, but we're still talking about a category 2 hurricane, and we don't expect that wind shear to continue for too much longer. Here's a great way to illustrate that. And I want to sort of break down where we're looking at a favorable environment for development and where we're looking at a not favorable environment. So what we want to see is the green. And you can see that's probably not going to be good for the storm here, which we want, and we don't want to see the red. That's where conditions are more favorable for development. There's the current placement of the storm. There's Dorian right there, and you can see it's got a lot of red around it, and you can see a little bit of yellow here indicating some of that wind shear and dry air. Now, there's the placement of the storm by Saturday morning at 8 o'clock. And there is basically just red all around it. And that's why the Hurricane Center is projecting that this will continue to strengthen into a Category 4 storm. We hope that's not going to be the case, but I think that's a really good possibility at this point as we get closer to Monday and Tuesday. The big impact I think we're going to see from this, because of the fact that it has slowed down, is the potential for some very heavy rainfall, flooding, freshwater rain, very much a possibility, especially here close to where the storm arrives along the Florida East Coast. You can see some of these amounts, and I've seen some amounts even closer to 20 inches here. As we get closer to Lake Okeechobee, you can see maybe closer to 7 to 10 inches. I just want to tell you, though, this will likely change. If this storm ends up turning a little bit earlier and going to the north, then we would hardly see any rainfall from this. But if it delays that turn, we would see this area here continue to shift a little bit farther west. So that's one of the things we'll have to continue to watch. As far as the wind potential is concerned, based on some of the latest information we're seeing this morning, this is the wind swath. So that's where we're looking at those hurricane force winds. You can see that corridor there from the northern Bahamas and close to the coast of Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, maybe a little farther north, maybe a little bit farther south. We'll have to see. But if it does take that turn early, then we would just see some tropical storm force winds on our coast in southwest Florida. If it's a little bit later, the winds could get a little bit higher. But the good news for us is that we're on the western side of the system, and usually with tropical systems, that is the weakest side of the storm, and it's also having to go through all this land area before it gets closer to southwest Florida, so it would be a much weaker storm by then. We're continuing to break down some of this latest information, and coming up in your first alert forecast, I will show you the latest European model from overnight. It's been pretty consistent. We'll break that down for you coming up in just a few minutes.